Many of these technologies being developed in AI will have a very strong influence on our daily life in the future. The technology that we've developed in our research is being used in hospitals every day. There's hardly any better way to create real-world impact. My name is Daniel Rückert. I conduct research in the field of medical image processing and specialize in integrating artificial intelligence into image processing to make better diagnoses for patients.
AI, artificial intelligence, is changing our world. Daniel Rückert and his team are bringing this revolution to the field of medicine, making the invisible visible, recognizing tumors, diseases, changes, with even better and more complex imaging technologies. AI has three major fields of application that build upon each other.
The first step is how the image data is generated, how to generate better images, and how to generate them faster. The second big step is that the image data, for instance anatomical structures, tumors, are quantified and extracted. The third step is to take this extracted information and interpret it. AI is actually very important in all three steps. And of course, this is not only of benefit to the radiologist, who may have an easier job interpreting the images, but in the long run also to the patients, who will hopefully have a better diagnosis at the end of the whole process.
Generating better images, identifying what they show, and ultimately making diagnoses according to these findings. In all three steps, artificial intelligence opens up new possibilities. Rückert's team is improving imaging and processing. Some questions can only be addressed through AI. How does the human brain develop in the early stages and in the first weeks after birth? With conventional methods, it is largely impossible to obtain images and answers. The fetus moves too much and too unpredictably. The data of the magnetic resonance image are full of motion distortions. Artificial intelligence in image processing can calculate these distortions and thus generate better images of the fetus's brain in the mother's womb. But with the images obtained, AI can do even more. For example, it can combine the collected data from 200 scanned brains into a data set that shows how the brain normally develops in the first weeks after birth. A journey through the growing brain. Visualizations that provide a treasure trove of data for other research, for example, neurophysiological research. Recognizing challenges in medicine that steer their own research towards new horizons. The combination of analytical and creative thinking is exactly what Daniel Rückert loves about his profession.
Computer science is rarely considered to be very creative, but often we develop new methods and algorithms. And in my opinion, this requires a lot of creativity because you really need new approaches and new ways of thinking to solve problems.
And sometimes a new environment helps. Munich. The Humboldt Professorship leads Daniel Rückert to the tomb. After more than 20 years in London, it will be a new chapter for him and his family. For his research and for his colleagues here, a new groundbreaking impulse. As head of the new Institute for the AI in Medicine, Rückert is to combine the work of various research laboratories and clinics.
The great motivation to go to Munich is really to bring information technology and medicine closer together in one location. And it's really a fantastic opportunity to bring them together here. The environment for this is perfect. Computer science is strong, medical science is very strong, and what is even more important, there is the will to closely link the two fields. And I believe this interlinking will really be an interesting direction in the future to make progress.
Computer scientists and radiologists from clinical practice who speak a common language. In the future, this will be deepened in order to open new doors.
The point is to use artificial intelligence or machine learning to actually find answers to medical questions that we currently cannot answer.
In the future, 50% of his work will therefore be set up here at the University Hospital. This is where Rückert's research meets those who apply it, and and the patients it helps.
The advantage is the spatial proximity, that you're really integrated, so to speak. You're in the hospital. And in the interactions with medical colleagues, it's also very important that when you have a new idea, when you have a question, you can simply walk two doors down and share it. And then you can hear what perhaps makes sense and what doesn't.
The computer is already better at some things than the human being, because it analyzes images without becoming fatigued, because it detects anomalies by comparing them to hundreds of thousands of images. Big data with which systems of machine learning are trained and even higher computing power have brought artificial intelligence a big step forward, especially in the field of image processing. Nevertheless, it is only the beginning, and many questions are still unanswered.
I think we're still a long, long way from building systems that are as intelligent as we as humans define intelligence. However, we have made tremendous progress for specific applications, using machine learning techniques to interpret images, genetic data, or other data, for example. We can now do this better than any single human being. I think we're still only at the beginning. And to be honest, it's also very exciting to not always know exactly what possibilities such new technology has to offer. And of course, all the time, you must keep in mind that you have to do your research in a socially acceptable way.